friends, Running Kimono here. So I have assembled this little list of like top hacks, ways to get like the best shopping experience over at Bath & Body Works. As many of you know, we're going to have a collision of Black Friday and Candle Day happening very quickly, and you want to have the best tips and tricks to have the most amount of success over there, and it is fun. The first one is to basically know the dates. And how do you know the dates of when the Black Friday sale or Candle Day sale will start? It's to get on their email list. Typically, the day before, evening-ish, they'll send you an email out saying, hey, Candle Day is tomorrow. Hey, Black Friday is taking place for the following week. And these are the dates for Black Friday. It's from the 23rd to the 27th, so that beautiful week. And then the rumored dates for Candle Day is the 4th to the 6th. They are trying to extend it so they can get more shoppers in there and to avoid the big crowds this year. So make note of those dates and make sure you sign up for the email list so you get them as well. Okay, for a lot of us, we might be more comfortable to shop online. And for those dates, what I would recommend is when you get the email that day, perhaps go online, fill up a basket, and then see when it hits midnight what the prices are of the candles or the items that you wish to purchase. It's always good to check, you know, see how things are shaking out. And I would always opt for the little bit more expensive shipping. They have the cheapest and the one above that, so your order gets fulfilled sooner, just so there are no cancellations or you get that email of doom saying, hey, sorry, part of your order has been canceled. Aha, the cost. So the magical cost is $9.95 for the large 3-wick candle. That is the rumor and the buzz right now. That is going to be the cost. So it's jumped up a little bit in price, but hey, it's still cheaper than $24.50. If you're doing this online, unfortunately, you can't use coupons with, because you have to use the code, whichever they will provide for us on Candle Day. It's not going to be this one. But as you can see, there's a limit online. You have to use that code. So thus, you can't use the percentage off or whatever you might have, which kind of isn't, you know, it's kind of sad, but hey, it is what it is. It's still really inexpensive candles. So looking at the math two different ways with a 10 off of 40 or a 20% off coupon. So say you have that 10 off of 40 mailer, I would grab 4 candles. So at the price point of $9.95, that's $39.80, and then grab a pocket back for $1.95 for a total of $41.75. Present that 10 off of 40, you're left with paying $31.75 for the 4, making it $7.93 per candle. If you have a 20% off, present one of those coupons, and then you're paying $7.96 per candle. And with that 20% off, you can obviously grab more, but just to show you the math, that's how it shakes out. Now, these are the mailers that I have right now. I received this one this week, which is the 10 off of 40 in the middle. As you can see, that would work perfectly with Candle Day. So boom, there it is. There have been other coupons also floating in and out. They are red ones, which include this one. But as you can see, this one is a 20% off from the 30th to the 24th. So haha, I could use that during Candle Day. And then there were some on top that I could use for the Black Friday sales as well. Now, some stores might actually put extra coupons at the front of the store, so keep your eyes peeled when you're in there shopping around the holidays. And if you ask an employee super nice, like, hey, would you have an extra 10 off of 40 or a percentage off, they will try to bend over backwards, because that's like the way that they are over there. They try to be super nice to make customers super happy. So don't be shy to ask or to keep your eyes peeled to look for this sort of thing. The last couple Candle Days, you know, people will sometimes only go in there to grab the free item and then leave the rest of their coupon. And then the staff always share them with others. So don't be shy to ask. Be super nice. Now, how do you get on the mail list? You can ask at the store. They'll take your first and last name, your mailing address, and your email. Or you can call this 1-800 number on the right to get on the list to get these mailer coupons sent to your home. Alternatively, if you live in a bigger city, this is only in certain states, the Bath & Body Works app is really kind of cool. And you can get coupons, percentage off. And then if you get like, you know, a certain amount that you buy per month, you also toss in free gifts, also free gifts for birthdays. So if you live in a bigger city, you might want to check out this app to see if your, you know, city is participating with this app. That would be really great. But it's only, I think, in 13 states. It's very limited right now. So this is a couponing channel, so we're all about saving money. And one of the fastest ways to get gift cards towards your Bath & Body Works purchase, well, it's the Fetch Rewards app. I would use the Fetch Rewards app, photograph your receipts to earn points, and when you hit the $25 mark or $27, You can get a Visa gift card and use that towards your Bath & Body Works purchase. It's a really easy process. You just go to the link in the notes, use my referral code, photograph a bunch of receipts, and your receipts will give you points, points towards gift cards. And as you can see, when you get $27 in points or $27,000, you can get a $25 gift card that you can use for this. So, I mean, sign up today. My code's there, right there on the screen. And when you photograph your first receipt, you're given $2. So if you have a bunch of receipts, you might get really close to that gift card. And if you want to use that Visa gift card and go to bathandbodyworks.com, buy yourself a $25 e-gift card. Very easy to do. You could probably even do it in store. And you can just scan that, because I know that sometimes to ask a cashier to type in your Visa card, to punch it in manually, sometimes they struggle with that, or with new hires, if they're not sure how the cash register works. Y'all know what I'm talking about. It might be easier just to go on the Bath & Body Works site and to get a virtual or a physical gift card mailed to your home. And you can do that, no sweat, with that Visa gift card from Fetch. Now, the day of a really big sale, for either Black Friday or Candle Day, the store will open 1 to 2 hours earlier than it's supposed to open. So if your store is in a mall, that might not be the case. But if it's its own deal, like if it's in a strip mall or something like that, and it has its own door to open and close, that's not part of a mall, they might be open 1 to 2 hours earlier. So what I would do is to absolutely ask the staff, or if you're in the neighborhood, drive by early and see if they are open. I can't stress this enough, guys. If you are super organized, this is going to be the funnest trip ever. So you know what I would do? I would absolutely make a list. Go online, see the different scents, what they might have. If you are so brave, go to the store, scope it out, and really make yourself a pattern of how you want to move around the store so you can get in and out very quickly. And try and do this like the first day of the sale and just be super organized. The more organized you are, the easier this will be. So definitely have all of your ducks in a row, know where you're moving around in the store, what you want to buy, the amounts, the cost, all that stuff. It'll be a great time. Also, be in the know. They have the most generous return policy. If you might be in a mad rush and you grabbed a candle, or it's just not your thing when you bring it home, and you're like, what did I buy? You can always return stuff. You don't even need a receipt. They're really, really, you know, they'll bend over backwards to make customers really, really happy. And this is like the biggest savings of the year between Black Friday and Candle Day. And you saw the math earlier in the video, like this is going to be a spectacular sale. So hopefully you guys are as excited as I am. And I just wanted to share a couple things I've been finding online. These things have just been popping up. Look at this 12 Days of Christmas with the gingham scent, $85. This is an online only exclusive. So can you not imagine, like, after Christmas, if that was like $40, that's something I think I might be buying. And for whatever reason, that Royal Polar Bear for $40, I swear to God, I saw it online for $5. Maybe I was half awake, but maybe that's my dream. But I think I saw it really cheap and then I woke up. We have a water snow globe on a pedestal for $60. My gosh, those are so cute. They always sell out really quickly. And then I really hope I find one of these. They are $19.99 and it is Bath & Body Works Christmas ornament. I love this idea. I think it's so super, uber cute. In the comments, let me know what you're trying to find and what your favorite scents are. I would love to read that. I'm kind of a Bath & Body Works nerd myself and a collector of all things pretty from them. I just think that this company, above and beyond the customer service, and I just love collecting candles. It's my thing. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye, guys.